graphics, I've done tattoos, I've done a handful of this here and there. I've also been art department on various film projects here in the Albuquerque area. I didn't always know I was going to be a artist, let alone a digital artist. I wanted to drop everything and be a hip-hop dancer when I was 17, everyone does. And basically what happened was I had enough money to either put myself through dance school for a few months or buy myself a laptop. And so I went to 3 tryouts a day for the dance school I wanted to attend, fell on my butt doing a handstand, and went and bought the laptop. So from there, I got my first tablet, digital tablet, and I started drawing all the time because of its accessibility. And from there, my skill level went up and up and up just because I was drawing all the time. So my first legit art job was doing windows at this place called Box Pizza. And, you know, that was my first, you know, commercial art job, and it was really cool. I didn't start digital art until around summer of 2017. This is what I did at Christmas. I scented out my face because that was when I scented my face. It was on DeviantArt, guessing on this. And then around the time that I started work for the film and theater production company at Sarkis back in the beginning of 2018, I was asked to do various film posters. This one was for a student film called Gods of Liberation. And it circulated around the main character, Mason, and a whole bunch of other characters, and this was the basic sketch layout that I did for that poster. And here's the line art that I did visually over top of that after I imported it into my computer. And the program that I used for most of my digital art career has been GIMP 2.8. I switched between that and Final Packet a little bit, but now I do use a bootleg version of Photoshop CC. Thank you,
Dave. Cool.
Okay, that was the finished colors.
With the faces, you do like a highlight, a midtone, and a shadow, or like a midtone and a shadow?
What I'll usually do is a midtone and a shadow, yeah. So I'll do the basic colors of skin and do a cell shading over that. Depending on the project, I will blend that or just leave it as a cell shading. And, you know, in that complexity, I'll add a highlight or a secondary shading under that. Here is a personal project. I don't know how many of you here know Attack on Titan, probably most of you.
I'm not familiar with it. Is it a video game? Oh, it's an anime. Okay.
It kind of had this big boom back in 2012, the first season of it came out. It had a big manga following until then. It had a big boom. And then it took forever for season 2 to come out. And then when it did, it's like, oh, it did come out?
It did!
Okay, now everyone's excited again. So. Because drawing straight lines digitally can be a little bit tricky, especially if you don't have screen tablets to work on, which I don't.
Wait, so you are using like a Wacom or what?
Yeah, a Wacom and Philips.
Okay.
The smallest version.
Yeah, so a Wacom, guys, is like a little pad that you plug into your computer. So when you're drawing, you don't draw with a mouse. You go like this with a little pen.
Yeah, it's about yay big. A stylus that goes within a pen that plugs in the computer and you look at the screen and you draw on the thing. Which at first using it can be really disorienting and you think, oh, I can't draw anything with this, it's impossible. But after a while it gets to be really natural and you
have
to do it.
Because
like
you can't see anything like where you're drawing. You have to look at the screen and draw here. And so it's tricky.
At first. But then you get totally used to it and I prefer it to a screen tablet now. Then I did a basic color swatch, and I will do generally fill in the single characters with one color and have that on a separate layer. I'll do color blocking for each individual character, and that way I can lasso select that, and when I color for real, everything will stay within the lines, and that's how I like to work. And so you can tell that the two on the other ends there are not done, and the ones in the middle have the shading and all that. Specifically for this Titan, I wanted to give it a sickly kind of appearance, so I put a lot of yellow into the skin tone to make it look jaundice. I put a overlay on the background to give it a texture, and it's like basically a picture of a flower bush. And then here's the completed image full of shading with light effects, and it's all done. And I like to put texture over the top of everything just to give it more texture without, because that's kind of the trick with digital art, it's generally making it look traditional. Traditional being paints, pencils, whatever, because it naturally has a grain of like paper or whatever tools you use to do it. And so a lot of the time digital can look too clean and it doesn't look good. So adding textures like this really does help. This one was a project for Bay's birthday. and sadly enough, he found out about it too soon and it spoiled the surprise, but somehow he's getting it for Christmas instead. A Van Gillian over there just recently came to Netflix and Rocketeer, another movie from the 90s, early 90s. And it's basically just a scene of the party, but I wanted it to be a kind of Western cartooning style versus an Eastern anime manga style. And so it has mirroring in it. So you've got Rocketeer over here, very Western, 1940s. And over there you've got the very Japanese Evangelion with mech suits and all that. And I wanted it to be one against the other and also be one against the other there and there. And I wanted it to be a fairly simple color palette layout later on, but also in the style of old movie posters from the golden age of cinema that were all very painterly and laid out in a certain way that draws the eye. And I called it A Van Tier. Here's the finished line art for it. As you can see, he's got a grenade and a Hauser. And down there, that in Japanese, it says one shoto, which is one shot for one shot comics. And again, it's the play between Western versus Eastern, but in a fun kind of way. I did like little Dr. Seuss clouds around it, from jetpack clouds and all that. And just, I really like it because it's fun. It pops out and it's a clean read. And that's something I really like in my work specifically, is a clean read. Here is basic color mapping for it. Just color blocking, just to get the idea of what I want to do. It's always good when I can go into it knowing exactly what I want to do with it, because then it will come out so much quicker and cleaner. If I go in and I just, I don't know, and I play around with it and I play around with it, there's a good chance that it's going to come out completely different than what I entered it with. And then here's the finished piece. I've got a lot of layers in this one, upwards of like 30, 40, 50. And I don't know if you can tell, but I did put a screen tone over it. And that's just, again, to give it that texture. And so it looks more like a comic book or a mega panel, but it's also done in the way that old golden cinema movie posters were. It's not quite the same painting style, but even still. Drawing diagrams are basically all the same. So you have your where the canvas goes, you have your color swatches, you have your tools, and then you have your layers. And usually what I do is I'll go in with a sketch layer first, and it'll be just that. And then I'll lower the opacity so that it's very faint, and then I'll do the finished ink lines on top of that, and that's a different layer. So I'll have two layers. And depending on complexity, if I want to have something behind something else, we'll separate it into multiple different layers. And then the color layer, again, we'll go on a different one. It'll generally go underneath of the line art layer. I'll usually turn that off once I have the line art done. And then this is multiple different layers past that. And so basically what I have here is the color, shading, then I have secondary shading, and then I have screen tone over that, and I have various different color washes over the top of that to try and homogenize the color a little bit, again, to get that clean read that I like. So that's that one. This is Bert Sanchez. This is a commission I got to do, quote unquote, a beautiful Rick Sanchez. And this is what I ended up with. I had the Mountain Dew up there in the top because after I added the portal, it seemed pretty much like a soda ad.
lively. His facial expression and things, it's hard to do.
I look at it a lot, so.
Yeah.
I gotta send some block.
Yeah, it's probably burned to the back of your elbow.
This one over here is curling. It's something to look at. And this one over here is glowing. It's glowing.
She's a digital artist.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I did that.
That was dope.